What's going on, everybody? It's me, Brennan, back again with another reaction. This is a big one today. This is the first PlayStation Showcase in like a year and a half. 2021 was the last time we had one of these. And I'm expecting a lot of big games to be shown here. Yesterday, I was in New York City. I went to a concert, so I wasn't able to watch this. I tried to stay radio silent on these things. I can't believe the thing's an hour and 13 minutes, almost an hour 14. So I think I know one or two things that are in this, but I'm not going to go ahead and you know, say them because I want to be surprised if that's true. So let's go ahead. We're going to react to this PlayStation Showcase. I'm very excited. If you've never seen any of my reactions to these big directs from like Xbox or Sony, you know, we're always wishing for a Dino Crisis remake. We are always, you know, Spider-Man would be really nice. There's rumors that there was like Metal Gear Solid stuff going to be in this, so that'd be really cool. Silent Hill 2 would be pretty neat. I doubt anything Resident Evil will be here, but, you know, we always wish for on this channel Dino Crisis reboot. So we're going to go ahead and we're going to get started. We're going to react to this because this is a long video. And I also got to get to work. All right, here we go. Tekken would be cool. Mortal Kombat as well. Gameplay. Okay. Spider-Man in a start would be pretty cool. Okay, game from Haven.
You want to know about us? Seems like everyone does these days. It's simple. Too much money and too much power is held by just a few people. And it's only getting worse. So, we decided to do something about it. Let's go.
Oh, is this gonna be like a live service game? That's pretty cool. PS5 NPC. They're gonna do these like crazy transitions like they did with the PS5.
Hi everyone. I'm Jim Ryan, President and CEO of Sony Interactive Entertainment. I'm delighted to be here today to introduce what's next for PlayStation 5. We're now into the third year of the life cycle of PS5, and we've been fortunate to have so many fan favorite titles released on the platform. What's even more exciting is that developers are just scratching the surface of what's possible with the gaming experiences that they create. Today, you'll get a glimpse into some of the most breathtaking and imaginative content that will be coming to PS5 and PlayStation VR 2. And now, what you've all been waiting for. Enjoy the show.
Yes, sir, Jim.
Super Earth, our home, our way of life. But freedom doesn't come free.
No! Sweet liberty! No!
Is that real?
Look familiar? Scenes like these are happening all over the galaxy right now. And you could be next. That is, unless you make the most important decision of your life. Prove to yourself that you have the strength and the courage.
Oh, is this Helldivers?
Free. Join the Helldivers.
Yeah. That first game was so much fun.
Experience true freedom.
Oh my god, third person, dude?
The freedom to travel the galaxy and secure the resources we need to build a better tomorrow. The freedom to encounter fascinating life forms and introduce them to our sophisticated technology.
Oh man. This looks cool.
The freedom to make new friends and represent the best.
They're making those live service games that, you know, everybody's been talking about that Sony should get. And that Sony also said they wanted to make. This looks awesome. I love it. That looks awesome.
Become a legend. Become a Helldiver.
Helldivers 2. PS5 NPC. Let's go. That looks awesome. That looks really good. I'm sorry, I feel like it's really loud, but that could just be me. Now I feel like that's too.
But do not engage.
Oh, is this gonna be Dragon Age?
Maybe engage a little.
Oh, I'm not. This game looks insane. This game looks done too. Immortals of Avon. This game looks sick. That's all, yeah, July. That looks really good. Oh, is this, God, I have this game, the Runner game. Yeah. Yeah, the first one's really good. I never got to beat it, though. It's freaking awesome. Dude, it is so loud. It's coming through really loud for me. Blood Will Run. Ghost Runner 2. That's what it was. Awesome game. These are solid titles right now.
What's your plan? Knowing you have only 66 days.
Resident Evil? No. This looks nuts.
Let you live. What suit did you sell?
Oh my God. This game looks insane.
Time is not on his side. All we have to do is wait. Yes. Let's kill him with time.
Wow. This game looks unreal.
Knowing you have only 66 days to live.
The combat looks insane. The visuals look insane.
Give my heart back.
Not PS5. That game looks sick. The combat is nuts. That sounds like Devil May Cry. Is this Journey? And Journey, yeah.
Hmm.
One of my favorite parts about Journey is when you're like surfing the sand going down, and it looks like they're making an entire game about that. Yes, please. Oh. Wow. That looks awesome. They're dropping no more PC on some of these.
A new world awaits you, full of dangers and mysteries, signs and wonders. Things that I, in my garden, could never have imagined.
Think of the world we could build if we believed in ourselves. If we truly believed in what it means to be sentient.
So loud, I was like, my God.
Would be possible if we believed, if we still had faith.
The Talos Principle, too. I think I have that game. Oh, I loved Greece. I love this art style. Really good. Definitely gonna have to play that. Cat Quest. I never got around to playing these games. Cute though. Looks really good. Naval combat. Spider-Man, no. Square Enix. Gonna be a multiplayer game. Why? That character kind of looks familiar. Splatoon, but not Splatoon. Seriously, though. It's literally Splatoon. What the hell? As somebody who's really into Splatoon right now, this is kind of weird. I don't... This can be a free-to-play game or games of service. It's literally Splatoon. That's like a killer whale. Stars. I don't know about that one. I don't know about that one. Oh man.
Land of Mojo. Here we find Jot, the plucky squire, and his friends, Violet, Thrash, and Pip. Our heroes protect the land from the villainous sorcerer, Hundrunner. They adventure to the edges of their realm, and even beyond. There, Jot finds a whole new world to explore.
Oh my god.
With dangers, surprises, and attractively furnished accommodation. Our heroes must battle Hundrump across the two realms.
These games look amazing.
They are to save their beloved land from his diabolical designs. Off the page and into adventure.
That looks awesome. That looks so cool. A Devolver game? It's probably going to be on everything. But that looks so cool. I mean, this is gonna be nuts for full destruction. It's like the best part about Burnout 3 and Revenge and all those is the takedown modes. Or the stunt mode. Man, art style is in such a good spot right now. This is like, you get like these really high graphics with like atmosphere and then you get the crazy destruction and gameplay of like modern games. This looks really cool too. So do you have to like steal things, I guess, or? Tear down. That game looks cool. Oh, by Saber, okay. Cool. We're going in. Something's in that. Oh. Oh, Jesus. Can't see. It's all pixelated. The hell is this? Oh, shit. It's Snake. This is a Snake Eater. The remake. What a thrill. With darkness and silence through the night. This was a rumored. Which is awesome because this is a series. I played 4 and I never played any of the other ones. Dude, he looks great. That's it though. See my master collection. Oh man, yeah. I'm gonna play them all right there. There we go. I've been actually really waiting to play those games. For something, because it's been rumored that, you know, Snake Eater was coming out, so now's the time. Oh, that's really cool. Well, that was actually, that was Big Boss, wasn't it? Oh, wow. Final Fantasy. These people live with a knife.
You have to believe us. We'd help you if we could.
But you're helping us already.
We never asked to be saved. Did you think we'd thank you? They'll never forgive us. We're all marked now.
Every time you show your faces, it is we who suffer.
You better hope so.
Crystals take more than they give.
You mean to tell me that the mother crystals are the reason the world is dying?
To hell with talking. If they won't give us a say, we'll decide our fates another way. Are you with me?
You will pay for what you've done.
Why aren't you dead? You are the bottom branded.
Tell me true. Do you believe what I'm about to do is wrong?
I was forced to kill. You do it by choice.
They don't believe in me. They believe in the power.
I think it's this Final Fantasy. I've been trying to avoid all the trailers for this game. It just looks really good. I haven't even seen the combat. I know it's like Devil May Cry-like, but that's what it looks like.
Salvation. We'll save ourselves. We'll do it on our own terms.
Come to me, Ifrit!
Yeah.
Who are we? What are the dominants? We are but mighty black
Oh my god. Kaiju battles?
I would be the king of the world.
The darkness has taken hold of you. It has made you forget yourself.
I don't want to be a monster, Clyde.
I have to stop him. I have to save him.
I made a promise to my friends, and it is they who will give me the strength to end your reign. Your efforts will avail us naught. We fight. We survive. We endure. We don't need a reason.
Fly!
This game looks really good, dude. Comes out next month. Huh? That looks awesome. Got like a whole nother like 40 minutes. Oh man.
I'm trapped here in this nightmare. I write to escape.
Oh, Alan Wake.
Every word is a step forward.
Feels like I've been waiting forever for this game.
Into darkness.
I'm glad you're on this case with me, Anderson. It's right up your alley.
The victim was one of their own. FBI Special Agent Robert Nightingale.
So you knew our victim?
Only the rumors. He was chasing a writer.
Someone knew they were here.
They got the guy who was Max Payne in another game. Awesome.
Killer left a message.
That's Sam Lake. It is. Holy shit.
We were all trapped in a horror story. The horror story wanted us dead.
Alan Wake was just a master class of a game. I love that first game so much.
There's something. I'm forgetting. Something important. Something's not right!
Easy now. First things first. What's your name?
Yeah, I gotta replay the first one. There's a remaster I didn't even get to play. It comes out in October. Nice. Definitely by getting that one. Oh, Sam Lake's in it too? Hell yeah. Assassin's Creed. This is a Mirage one, the narrative, like linear.
Welcome, Hidden One.
Yeah, I think that's the return to form, like 10-hour Assassin's Creed game.
And been reborn.
To get you inside without being seen. You could bribe the guards to look the other way.
I shall see what flavor best suits me.
Man, I used to play these games like crazy. I loved Odyssey, but after that, I was like, I can't play these like 80-hour games anymore. Well, Odyssey, I think, actually took me, like, 50 or more. But I know Valhalla is, like, at least a minimum 80 to 100 hours. I'm like, no, not for an Assassin's Creed game. But if this is a return to form, a linear story, you know, 10 to 15 hours, I'm definitely interested. Oh.
We may be watching.
Nice. Cute. Damn, they're just throwing all the games at us. I'm gonna assume they're saving Spider-Man for last. I'm gonna assume side games. These games look so good though. Like almost all of them look really good. Art style goes a long way. Make this is cool. This looks cool as hell. Look at these monster designs. Oh my god. A Capcom game? No, side games. The anime aesthetic like goes so it's so perfect for the video game format. I love like look how good this game looks. Grand Blue Fantasy. Okay. I figured it kind of looked like some of those characters. But, I mean, I have another. Street Fighter 6! Are they going to show the first DLC character? Or just a hype moment for.
I've crossed paths with many during my journey for true strength. I've also met my share of enemies, opponents I had to overcome. My journey knows no end. I will continue to do what I have always done.
When you said you were seeking strength, despite having no real need to do so, honestly, I thought you were a complete idiot.
The boy.
He was set up.
I'm not nearly strong enough to chase after a monster like that.
It's probably worth looking into this nice shawl business.
That power seemed to be the Satsui no Hado. Was it simply a trick of the senses?
Bison? He attempted to set the world under his heel through violence.
A veritable madman.
When you go looking for strength, it's not like
this looks good.
This journey doesn't have a real ending.
Can't wait, man. Next week. Oh. Cannot wait for this game. Oh, look at those. PlayStation Store exclusive. Oh, titles and stickers. Art style's insane on these games. kind of looks like Castlevania-esque. Ultros. That looks really cool. Now. Oh. No. It's really cool, dude. Perfect World Games. A mech game? Interesting for sure. Tower of Fantasy. That looks cool. Dragon's Dogma. Yeah. Two. I tried playing the first game a bunch of times. I love the mechanics, but I just never sat with it. I'm gonna definitely give the second game a go. Because the combat, I think, is phenomenal in these games. And the design, like, it's Capcom to a T. Combat was nuts in this game. Pawn system. Oh god, these are horrifying.
That is most unfortunate. But it doth not release thee from thy fate.
Think about Dragon's Dogma, the original still holds up, like, graphically.
Welcome back for another week of career fulfillment and minimal social interaction.
Five Nights.
We know how challenging it can be to
is
find
that,
a place
like,
where
I know
you feel
that
you truly belong.
That first person
and
one,
that treats you mostly with respect.
I don't know what, how to explain it, but the newerish one came out a couple years
reason,
ago, I think.
We are excited to inform you that you did an adequate enough job the first time around to have you back. Also, there were no other applicants. So strap yourself in and get motivated to an appropriate degree. Because you ain't seen nothing yet.
Oh boy. Nice. Jump scare. Yep. I even knew it was coming. God. I tried playing that game. I'm like, I just hate jump scares. I'm like, this friggin' sucks. There you go. Some PSVR 2 titles. Resident Evil. Resident Evil 4.
How far could he have gone?
This game probably looks insane. That's the thing, though. Like, even with RE4, though, I feel like I'm just like, it's like playing it in the original in VR on Oculus is really cool, but like, I don't know. Maybe with the new graphics, like, it'll be a little more intimidating. But it's just like, I don't know. It's like RE Village, I could find truly unsettling just because of what it is. This one, it's like you're chasing and stuff. Like, gameplay-wise, this game's gonna be awesome. Yeah. But, and, I mean, there's the garage door and stuff like that. What I'm trying to say is, I like RE4 a lot, but it's also not the scariest one. So, it would be crazy to get something nuts.
Oh, forgive me, Father. I've sinned. Like, a lot. You see, everything started 2 years ago when I met Fred. And ever since then, it's like I see his face everywhere. And lately, I've started to develop
this Arizona sunshine for their VR or something.
What do we have here?
Like a PSVR version.
Hello, uglies. Blah, 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 blah. And since I met my new best friend, I guess I get a little overprotective. Okay, very overprotective. I'd love to sit here all day and chew your ear off. I'll be right out, boy. But as you know, time waits for no man. Catch you later, Fred. Who's a good boy? Woo! Looks like today's gonna be a scorcher.
Like Ghost Squad. I love that game. Crossfire Sierra Squad. Game looks sick, dude. That game's probably awesome. I can't buy another VR headset. Synaptic tech.
We need that intel by any means necessary. It's connected to a mind synchronization device. This is cutting edge interrogation tech. We're out of time and out of options. We've got to go in.
Ah, yet another lamb to the slaughter. Well, come on then.
I know that voice.
Is ticking. You have to adapt.
This looks really cool.
Pathetic. Your heroics mean nothing.
You're getting close. You're approaching the center of his subconscious.
You think you're a threat to me? I'll never talk. They'll never break me.
That looks awesome. 4th of July. Gotta turn this down, right? Yeah, cuz copyright. I wish they'd give you a warning, cuz I just don't want the copyright nonsense. Nice. And we're back.
Got like another 20 minutes.
Is that it ever? Bungie. He's running a marathon. Looks really cool. Yep. Nice. Full on remake. I'm so happy they're doing something else than Destiny. And now Destiny. And Destiny's last expansion apparently was not good.
I don't even know where to begin. You've missed so much.
We're oh,
gods.
This is gonna be Destiny 3 tease.
Vanquish nightmares.
Oh, they're gonna do the final expansion.
Fought alongside
tease.
Those who we once fought against. I wish you could have been there.
Kate.
Yeah, me too, kiddo. But hey, I'm here now. Wherever the hell here is.
He's back? Whoo! Nice. That's awesome. That was like everybody really wanted him to come back, and we were like, ooh, please. And they did it. They somehow did it.
Seconds.
conquered. Very cool, very cool, very cool.
The best
Gran Turismo trailer. All right. I mean, I think the concept's interesting. I don't know if I'm gonna need to go see it in the theater though. And the fact that it like actually happened is kind of crazy. Getting closer and closer to Spider-Man.
Thank you for joining us today. Before we get into our final game, I have a few announcements to share. At PlayStation, innovation is our passion. And that applies to not just what games you play, but how you play them. Later this year, we will launch a dedicated device that enables you to stream any game from your PS5 console using remote play over Wi-Fi.
Whoa.
Internally known as Project Q, it has an 8-inch HD screen and all of the buttons and features of the DualSense.
Oh, this is the Vita-like thing they were talking about.
We look forward to sharing more information in the near future. I'm also pleased to reveal our first ever PlayStation earbuds, which will bring next-generation audio immersion to PS5 and PC. They simultaneously connect to smartphones via Bluetooth.
That's
new
cool.
Wireless technology will deliver lossless audio with low latency, giving you outstanding sound quality while you're playing. Look out for more details soon.
But you have to be close to your PS5 to use that
continued commitment
thing.
Delivering experiences that surprise and delight our players. I want to thank all of you for your unwavering support for PlayStation.
This is the last game? Is that Sam Witwer? It kind of looks like him. Oh, it's Kraven. It's Kraven.
Pathetic.
I'm just like, I'm looking at this guy. I'm like, who is this? I'm like, oh, shit. That had to be Sam Witwer.
I asked for an equal. And this is what you find.
Dude.
Sir. Perhaps a new hunting ground.
Oh my god, let's freaking go! We got Lizard? Okay.
Light the fires. The great hunt begins.
God.
Kraven's in it, dude. All right, let's see what we got going on in Spider-Man 2. Oh man, I got really big chills. Alright, I don't know why I'm getting really emotional. Oh my god. So he's protecting Kurt Connors. The black suit looks so weird.
Lizards across the river.
Oh man.
I'm not gonna make it in time.
All right. Switch to Miles.
Miles, the hunters tracked Connors to the Harlem Fish Market.
Lizard.
I'm on it. Sounds like Kraven's checking off his.
We don't have much time. Move.
Guess we'll chat later.
Oh, you got a wingsuit now.
Genki, the lizard's loose.
And Genki's in it? Oh, is Genki in it? Yeah, he was in it in the Miles game.
It's really tough hiding it from my mom, but yeah, I'll boot up and see you there.
They got here fast.
It looked like vulture tech.
Spread out. If you find the lizard, don't engage alone. Look at those fish. It's been feeding.
Never saw it coming.
Nice. Basically did like a Hadouken.
Right.
Cool.
Where are you, Connors? Garage my lead to him.
Yeah, he's definitely the lizard by now.
He's out of control.
Because he was teased in Miles' game at the end. How is he going to look? If they make him more like reptilian than like the humanoid face, oh man, I'm going to be so happy. Because a lizard can go one of two ways.
Just his skin.
Doesn't that mean he's getting bigger?
Hungrier too. Whoa. Hey man.
New threats? The building's swarming with hunters. Any sign of Connors?
Yeah. Genki's tracking him.
Hey, Mr. Parker. Mr.
Spider-Man, I mean.
But the data's incomplete.
Okay, I think I got a lock.
Gigi, wait, you chill.
Yeah, they did that suit.
That wasn't me.
Awesome.
I don't even have a stomach, so...
Let's go!
Oh, I definitely think he's more, reptilian, probably.
Can't lose Connors. Harry's dying, and he's the only one who can help.
We won't. You take the drones, I got the jet skis. Well, if I borrow this?
Harry's dying? So is Harry... I don't even know. Because I thought they really, kind of really teased that Harry was going to be Venom, man. Which I'd never like, but... Seems a little more on edge.
Poison clouds. That all you got?
Almost done here. Civilians are all safe. How you looking?
This gunship won't quit.
I'm right behind you. We'll take it down together.
No. I got you. Time to go boom, boys.
Oh, no. Spider-Man, it's got defenses.
Is there a lizard's gonna show up? Oh, dude, he looks awesome. They did him solid.
I do not want to be lizard food.
Oh my God.
He got away from us.
It's good, Pete. I saved the tracker. Let's go, man, before he gets too far.
No. He's mine.
You sure? He's got big teeth.
So do I.
He's not normally like that, right?
No. He's never like that.
Oh, it's like I just want to know more. I love that. Still no date, though. I mean, this was really solid.
It's time.
Helldivers looks so cool. Is there anything else? We'll pause. Right. Okay. I thought this was incredible. This was a really good showcase. They showcased a lot of new games, games that we now know are coming to their systems, a lot of big titles too. The Metal Gear Solid Snake Eater remake and the remastered collection is huge. I cannot wait for those. Spider-Man 2 just looks amazing. And it's coming out in fall. We still don't know a date yet, but I'm ready for that game. Even while watching the gameplay, I'm like, can we just get a story trailer? Like, just give me something like more, because I'm like, you know, how did he get the black suit? Obviously, we're not going to know and stuff, but like, oh, I'm so ready for Spider-Man 2. That game's going to be something else, man. And Insomniac really knows like the ethos of like Peter Parker and Spider-Man and even his villains and all that. And I'm so excited for that game, dude. Kraven looks amazing. I'm pretty sure that was Sam Witwer, that one hunter guy that he just offed in the woods, but I am so psyched, dude. All of these games looked really good, but there were some crazy ones in here too. Like, you got Dragon's Dogma, you had there was that Grand Blue game, there was the storybook game, Street Fighter 6 was shown, Final Fantasy 16 continues to look amazing, Alan Wake 2, Assassin's Creed Mirage, solid showcase, and everything looked just awesome. Like, you had the one game by the people who made Grease and all that other stuff. I am very excited for the future of PlayStation. I think this is a huge deal, the showcase, and they came and they delivered. So probably the next time we see them, we'll probably get a Spider-Man date soon, I'm assuming, and then we'll also be seeing some more rollout of the year, because there was a rumor that like Silent Hill 2 was going to come out this year as well, but I don't know. I thought Mortal Kombat also would have showed up here, but it didn't, so I'm curious when that's going to be showed. Probably Summer Games Fest. But that was my reaction to the PlayStation Showcase for 2023. This was insane. And like I said, Spider-Man, it looks insane. Helldivers, that game looks so sick now too. You got Marathon, the remake. Oh my God, so cool. I'm very excited to be a gamer. It's a good time, but there's just so many games. And the real question is, do we have enough time to play them all? I think, honestly, the weakest point in the showcase was probably that Splatoon knockoff, that Foam Stars game. I'm just going to keep playing Splatoon. But aside from that, everything looked solid, dude. And I'm very excited for the history or the future for PlayStation. So let me know in the comments down below what you thought about this PlayStation showcase. What game excited you the most? Probably for me, it's Spider-Man 2, but Marathon's a big deal. I even think the Destiny trailer is really cool that we're getting Cade back. There's just a lot to talk about here. Snake Eater just looks cool too. I felt uncomfortable because I'm like, what is this creature in the water? And I was like, oh, it's Big Boss. But anyway, that has been it for my reaction. I appreciate you checking out this video if you do, and again, let me know in the comments down below what your favorite game was in this Sony showcase. As always, my name is Brandon, and I will see you all next time.